Hello friends, so I have picked very beautiful questions today, two very beautiful questions. These are very nice and this method will help you to solve questions like this in the future. So let's read the question. F of x is equal to ax square minus bx minus 16. It's given that it does not have two distinct real roots, right? And they're asking what is the maximum value of 4a minus b. So first let's understand, what does this mean? It does not have two distinct real roots. So its discriminant either must be less than 0 or must be equal to 0. So let's write it down. D, we know it is b square minus 4ac for a general quadratic equation. And for this equation, it is b square plus 16 for the 64a, right? And we got to know that it must be less than or equal to 0. So let's understand what is the meaning behind this equation we got. So it means that we know that b square is never less than 0. Either it has to be 0 or it is always greater than, because greater than 0 because there is a square. So if this whole equation must be less than 0, it must be true that 64a is also less than 0. So for that, a has to be less than 0. So we deduce that a is less than 0, right? And they're asking what is the maximum value of 4a minus b, right? So let's understand, in 4a minus b, if we want this to be maximum, we know a has to be maximum and b has to be as minimum as possible. So we know that a has to be maximum and b has to be minimum, right? So let's get to know how to do this. So we got that a has to be maximum and b has to be minimum. So let's find out what is the value of a. From this equation, a is equal to minus b square by 64, right? So because since I don't want the inequality, because I want its maximum value, so this has to be the value. There has to be an inequality actually, but I am equating it to this value since I want its maximum. So if this has to be maximum of a, then let me find what is 4a. So I'll multiply by 4 on both sides. So if I cancel, it becomes 16, so equal to minus b square by 16. I'll also subtract b here itself. 4a minus b is equal to minus b square by 16 minus b. So let me take minus common, this becomes plus, and I'll take the LCM now, is equal to minus of b square plus 16b by 16. So for finding the maximum now, I'm going to factorize the numerator. So pause the video and try to do it, and then watch it further to see how I did it. Is equal to minus of b square plus 16b. I shall add and subtract 64 on the numerator. It actually doesn't make any difference since it becomes 0. So if I combine this, it becomes b plus 8 whole square actually. So minus of b plus 8 whole square minus 64 as it is divided by 16, right? So if I multiply minus back again, 64 minus b plus 8 whole square by 16, which is also the value of 4a minus b. Since I know it has to be maximum, and this term, this part, is always either equal to 0 or greater than 0, since square is there, as you know that perfectly. So what I'm going to do is, to check whether this is maximum or not, let's just try to put values. So if I put any value for b, this becomes a positive value and it decreases the value of numerator and decreases the maximum value. I mean, the value is less than the maximum value of 4a minus b. So which I don't want that to happen. So I want this term to vanish. So if I make this vanish, that means b is equal to minus 8. I have to put b is equal to minus 8 to make this term vanish. So I'll be left with 64 by 16, which is equal to 4. So if you put any other value other than minus 8, you'll be getting a value which is less than 4. Hence, the maximum value of 4a minus b, maximum of 4a minus b is equal to 4, which is the first option. So in this way, we have to solve this question. So let's see the second question. The second question says that given that there is only one real solution, x is equal to k, means this for the equation ax square minus 48x plus 144, this whole equation has only one real solution. It's given like that in the question, which is the k is the real solution. So obviously, first let me tell that please try this question by pausing the video and then you can see further. So let's see how to do this. So we are given that x is equal to k is the only one real solution. So obviously you people would have thought that the discriminant must be equal to 0. So let's equate the discriminant. Let's find the discriminant first. Discriminant is equal to b square, that is 48 square. I have the value of 48 square as 2304 minus 4 AC. 4 times 144 will be 576. So 576 A should be equal to 0. So A is equal to 4. From this you get it, right? So if you substitute 4 here, 4x square minus 48x plus 144 equal to 0. This is what you get, right? So if you cancel out 4, 12 and 4, 3s are 12, 2, 4, 4, 6 are 24. So you'll be getting a quadratic equation, x square minus 12x plus 36, which is nothing but x minus 6 whole square, right? So it is equal to 0. If I put the square other side, x is equal to 6. So you'll be getting x is equal to 6, which is also the value of k, right? So k is equal to 6, and they're asking the minimum value of a plus k. So a plus k is equal to 10. But let me tell you, this is wrong. This is the value of a plus k, which you got as 10. 10 is, option is there, be careful, but it is wrong. Let me tell you why. In the question, they have not mentioned anything regarding a. So this is only true when a is not equal to 0, right? There is a possibility that a is equal to 0 also. So let's check in that. If a not equal to 0, then only this remains as a quadratic equation, and then only there will be one solution, and then only you can put the formula for discriminant. But if a is 0, the power 2 term, this will vanish out, only this will remain. This is not a quadratic equation, and then you're not allowed to do you're not allowed to put discriminant for this equation. So let's check what happens when a is equal to 0. So this term vanishes out. I'll be left with minus 48x plus 144 equal to 0. So x is equal to k is equal to, I'll be getting it as 3, right? So x is equal to k is equal to 3. So we got k is equal to 3, and we have taken a as 0. So let's add both of them. A plus k will be equal to 3, which is less than 10. This is the minimum value of a plus k and not this. So our answer is 3, which is option B. Thank you for watching this video. I'm Skanda Prasad.